Who cares what I think?
Moonjumper here with another sub-episode of Who Cares What I Think, where I play a clip or clips from one or more of my main episodes of Who Cares What I Think, so that you can get a smaller bite of my thinking on a particular topic, and maybe it might even inspire you to check out the full episode or series of episodes, such as my multi-part review of Star Trek Lower Decks. Heck, you might even like, share, subscribe, and join in the conversation. Let's face it, Star Trek Discovery has pretty well been a disaster, particularly when it comes to blowing up canon and continuity, and so far, Season 3 is not changing my mind. Although, to their credit, Book is a cool character, and he actually did reference the Temporal Wars, or Temporal Cold War, established in Enterprise and supported by Voyager. So that's a little bit encouraging, but Discovery already nuked TOS era canon so badly, well, that's another video. The point is, Discovery aside, way aside, every Star Trek series we've ever had over the last half century has been rather different than every Trek series before it. Even though it's all set in the same universe, the same continuity, each has had its own unique style and premise, and that's how it should be. Okay, well, Discovery has been taking being its own thing to the extreme, but I digress. I'm going to play two clips from my series of Lower Decks review videos. It's another before and after. Clip one from before Lower Decks premiered, when all we had was a trailer to speculate what an animated comedy would bring to the table, and clip two from after I had watched the entire first season. Going in, I was skeptical that Lower Decks would ever deliver a series that was substantive. I thought it might be humorous, probably be enjoyable. I was also very encouraged that Lower Decks was going to return Star Trek to a canonical look, but I was not expecting the kind of deeper substance we got from, say, Star Trek the Animated Series from 1973. To my pleasant surprise, I was wrong. Roll the tapes. You know, not every Star Trek has to be the same. TOS and the first two seasons of Enterprise were both straight-up exploration adventures, and I think it's fair to say the same thing of Voyager. But think about Star Trek The Next Generation. There really wasn't all that much exploring going on. Yeah, I mean, every now and then you'd come across a Nagilum or weird spatial anomaly of the week, occasional first contact here and there, but Captain Picard was much more of an establishment diplomat than he was an explorer per se. Unlike the young Federation of the original series and pre-Federation days of Enterprise, where space was a wide-open, unexplored wilderness, basically the Wild West in space, the Federation of the TNG era is long established, comfortable, bureaucratic. The Enterprise D is more of a luxurious cruise ship convention center that floats around the already explored galaxy, hosting diplomatic dinners for alien ambassadors that the Federation has already had relations with for years. It was a very different kind of Star Trek than its action-adventure wagon train in space predecessor. Deep Space Nine, which is actually my favorite of all the series, or you could say it's a very close tie with TOS, was far different even still. A completely different kind of series. You know, the word Trek means voyage. There was very little trekking going on DS9. It was primarily a geopolitical drama set on an alien space station. Not a lot of exploring, but damn good writing. Deep and thoughtful writing, and by far the most fleshed out character development of any set of characters in the Trek universe to date. Discovery? right now, I'm not even going to try to define Discovery. That's another video. It's definitely its own thing. Now, Star Trek Picard is a little better. Love it or hate it, it at least takes place in a Star Trek universe, which is recognizable as the Star Trek universe. Not everybody likes the direction it took. Not everybody likes its darker tone, but it is a Star Trek universe we recognize both visually and in terms of familiar characters played by familiar actors, and plot threads with actual connections to previous canon. Again, not an exploration series in any way, instead it's an action spy-fi thriller set in the Star Trek universe, kind of different than what we've seen. So maybe Lower Decks won't have that high concept exploratory awe that Star Trek the Animated Series had. In fact, they've even said that this ship, the USS Cerritos, isn't about exploring strange new worlds.
Nothing like a cold beer after a smooth second contact.
That's what I'm talking about. Yeah!
But that doesn't mean that it might not be funny as hell. And as I said, if it's good, if it's well written, I can certainly enjoy it as a comedy, which just happens to be set in the Star Trek universe. Without spoiling too much, one of the best season finales we have had in Star Trek. I am not exaggerating. It is right up there with Best of Both Worlds. Multiple examples in DS9. Folks, this wasn't even all that comical. This was a full-blown drama with consequences, which I'm not going to spoil. You need to watch it. And stop the tape. Folks, thank you so much for checking out these before and after clips, and I will leave links and end cards so that you can watch my full in-depth multi-part review and analysis of Star Trek Lower Decks, just in case you actually care what I think. From deep in the heart of Texas, I am Moonjumper.
Who cares what I think?